Hello, everybody, and welcome to Test Preparation 23. My name is Steve Ford, and I have a question from Tabu, 17 years old, from India. So let's listen to her question about the TOEFL.
Hello, Steve. I am Tabu from India. I am 17 and I'm wanting to do TOEFL. It's my first competitive exam, and I have no idea how it's gonna be, because I have never faced any such kind of exams. I am very shy kind of person and scared about the exam. I need your advice, and can you just let me know how the exam is, how many rounds it has? I just don't know about the listening, reading and stuff. And how to prepare for the exam, where you have to how to study, how the teachers are, is it really nice and stuff. Thank you, and I really like your videos, they're really helpful and cool.
Hello Tabu and hello India. I can tell that you're very keen on getting started studying for the TOEFL. So Tabu, you're from India. What exactly do I know about India? Instead of giving you a boring and long lecture about all of the minute details in the sections of the TOEFL, I'm going to give you and the world a huge gift by sharing the tips for tackling each section of the TOEFL. Acha! That's good in Hindi, by the way. The reading section lasts from 60 to 80 minutes. There are 36 to 56 questions on three or four passages from academic texts, and you have to answer questions on those. So you can take notes to help you summarize information from the texts that you're reading. 1-point questions. Some students like it, some don't. Usually through the process of elimination, you can discard one of the possible answers right away. Your chances have increased by 25%. Then, if you have a good understanding of the text you're reading, you'll have eliminated two of the choices. So a lot of students get stuck between two possible choices. And please, there's no template, there's no formula, when in doubt, choose letter C. My best advice for you, all of you, is to practice reading sections for the TOEFL on your own. Some questions have special directions in which you need to choose and organize information.
Okay, so we have some other multiple choice type questions for the reading section. And you can see that they go from A all the way to F, so there are 6 possible answers. In this question, you want to select 3 of them to get the correct answer, and that will get you 2 points. We have letters A all the way to G, so there are 7 possible choices, and you have to organize them according to subcategories with a total of 5 choices, and that's worth 3 points. Sometimes it can even be worth 4 points.
One of the kinds of the questions from the reading and listening which is tricky is what can be inferred, what can be implied, what is the overall idea or meaning. Such questions are very subjective, and maybe your guess is a good one, but does not match up with the dude who wrote the test. All I can say is don't worry too much about such questions. There are not many of them, and if you feel you got the answer wrong, just move on to the next question. Don't freak out. The listening section lasts for 60 to 90 minutes and has 34 to 51 questions. There are different multiple choice formats for the listening section, like choose one answer, choose two answers, and note that there is a square around the letters for these ones, organizing 3 answers, categorizing answers. You're required to listen to lectures, classroom discussions, and conversations, and answer questions related to what you heard. You are once again allowed to take notes and use them when choosing your answers. Beginning in March 2013, last year, the listening and speaking section, just the independent ones for the speaking, includes other native speakers of English with accents from North America, the United Kingdom, New Zealand, or Australia. So my years of telling my YouTube subscribers and students that they need to be used to a wide variety of accents is now validated. Taking down the main points from a listening track is a skill that you acquire over time. I have two tips on note-taking for you. One, don't overestimate your ability to remember everything you heard when you are under pressure. Sometimes I get students who feel that the listening track was so easy, it's a piece of cake, that they didn't bother taking any notes. And then when it came to answering the questions, their mind went blank halfway through. Uh-oh. So even if it looks easy, please take notes and make sure you write clearly enough to read your own handwriting. Be careful not to write too much, especially for the longer lectures. Typically, the introduction given by the professor is simply general information that is to familiarize the listener with a topic. The information that counts comes after the introduction in longer lecture questions, and that's what the test questions will focus on. Well, Tabu, I promise that I will cover the speaking and writing sections in Test Prep 24, that's a promise, and I hope everybody watching this video will be able to take advantage of the tips that I have gathered since I started teaching TOEFL back in the 1990s. Have a great day, and bye for now. So please be sure to pace yourself on the reading section. Gesundheit. You'll familiarize yourself.